I think the use of technology within accounting education is an important factor of what we have to deal with, because it is part of, very much a part of the world that we live in nowadays. You can't go anywhere without seeing pretty much everyone on a mobile phone or reading something on a tablet, or they've got a laptop open and they're doing work. You don't see paper and pen as much nowadays as what you used to. And with the generations coming out of schools now, that is going to go even further that direction. We're going to see more and more people coming into class with laptops, with tablets, with mobile devices, and I suppose we just can't ignore that reality. So it is something that we're just going to have to deal with. I think we all have demands on our time, and especially academics, is, you know, there's pressure to research, there's pressure to publish, and whilst I love being able to talk to my students, there often just isn't the hours in the day to do it, especially when you've got large classes. And what I found was I was talking to students in consults about the same things over and over again. Now, the issue with that is if it's just on a really simple area, you know, well, simple, maybe simply explained, but if it's on a simple thing, then I figured, well, why, you know, repeat the same thing over and over? Why not just record it and make it available to them? And that's essentially what I did. And I have found that it's had two impacts. One, it saved me time. But secondly, when we do have discussions with students, we know that it's at that higher level, because they can go away and do that work and find those things out on their own before coming to us and then integrating those ideas. I make two main types of videos. The first are very small technical videos on just particular aspects. So it might be how to calculate a present value. It might be on how to calculate the provision for long service leave, or how to work out the impairment charge on property, plant and equipment. So with these particular videos, it just allows the students, if they are working at home late one night and they can't get in touch with me, because, you know, whilst I don't mind replying to emails from students and checking the discussion boards, you know, I'm not going to be getting back to something at 3 o'clock in the morning. So it allows them to get some instantaneous feedback on, you know, how to do a particular problem if they get stuck. And they can do that wherever, whenever that happens. The second type of videos I do are just a screen capture of the full lecture. Now, this helps in two angles. One, if a student happens to miss a lecture, they can sit down and watch it. The second is if they have been to the lecture, and this is the preferred way of doing it. And to be honest, most of our students, we haven't seen a drop off in attendance since this has happened. The second type is more if they've been to the lecture, but they just want to review it. Now, this is incredibly important, especially for our non-English speaking background students, because they come across terms which they may not necessarily understand or, you know, have come across before, and it allows them to see it back in context within the lecture itself. And so that's a second way in which we use it. What's in it for students is the ability to access resources whenever the need strikes and wherever in the world they happen to be. So they don't have to necessarily be in Sydney. They don't necessarily have to be looking at this stuff during normal business hours. Just if they happen to be looking at this work at, you know, 4 o'clock on a Sunday morning, for, you know, whatever reason they happen to be doing that at that time, but if they happen to be doing so and they want to get some feedback on how to calculate a present value, absolutely, they can go find something on it. If it happens to be, you know, they're away for work, again, they can go and have a look at this material. They don't have to carry a whole range of things with them. It's as long as they've got an internet connection, they can get access to it. In terms of the feedback, there's two elements to that. One is just usage, and second is the actual qualitative feedback that we get. In terms of usage, these videos have been really well used, both when they were just housed within the learning management system at UTS, as well as more open source through YouTube, people use them. And that in itself suggests that people are finding them valuable. In terms of qualitative feedback, the feedback comments they get up on my channel, the feedback comments I get through the student feedback surveys, the feedback comments we get through focus group sessions on, you know, not just on these particular videos, but just around the subject, have all been really, really positive. So the feedback that we do get from students, you know, is positive. They like them, they think they're worthwhile, and they do use them. This is actually quite hard to disentangle for two reasons. Firstly, when we had the analytics mapping to students, so the use of these videos to students within the course, what we found was everyone was using them. So we actually had no way to really run any analysis within a semester, because there was no comparison group within that particular semester. You know, across semesters for sure, we can, you know, look at differences in performance across semesters where they didn't have access to them to where they did. But during that same period of time, a range of other things were being instituted within the subject. So it's kind of hard to really say the videos did this and this, and, you know, these other things did that. As far as from my point of view, the qualitative feedback has been really good. They like them, they seem to use them. I think that would tend to suggest there is a benefit, but to actually nail it down, I can't say that. The second reason why it's difficult to do is because with the YouTube channel, we're not mapping student use directly to video views. So we just don't know who's using it or how much they're using it. It could be one person watching all the videos on repeat. I don't know. We do know they seem to be a lot of UTS students using them, because A, they tell us, and B, the usage spikes around the exam that we have and then drops away quite substantially after that. So that would tend to suggest that they're ours, but, you know, other people are using those videos as well. But yeah, coming back to it, is it having an effect? I'd like to think so. Can I be sure of it? No. But I think it is something that we need to think about, because it is the way the world is going, and it's almost going to be expectation that these sort of materials are available.